Aloha, everybody. All the five or so people that watch my videos. Another video about corals.
Okay, I know what you're thinking. Another video about corals, I didn't even watch the previous one, now again. Oh, go watch the previous one. It's good, believe me, it's good. There's so much more about this issue than just bleaching event of 2022. Coral bleaching is a physiological process that occurs, well, basically any time a coral feels too hot. And what is really important to understand is that corals are not dead when they are bleached. There is still a lot of hope for recovery. In order to understand what happens, you need to look at the process at a macroscopic level. Corals are animals, which is sometimes overlooked, and they live in symbiosis with microscopic algae. These algae actually physically occupy the coral inside, and they give them their colors. Now, you might wonder, one microscopic algae per coral, how does that work? Corals are huge. In fact, what you always see is not one coral individual, but a colony. And these colonies consist of multiple individual polyps, which are actually genetically identical clones of one individual. So a coral colony is built up of many, many individuals. Now, these algae are mutualistic endosymbionts, and they are embedded intracellularly inside of the polyp's cells. Their densities are quite large. Distributed across the coral surface, there can be from hundreds of thousands up to millions of symbionts per square centimeter. And the cellular structure that contains the algae, which are actually from the genus Symbiodinium, is called a symbiosome. And one single symbiont occupies one single symbiosome. The symbiosome is a membrane structure built by the coral and not by the Symbiodinium. And through this membrane, they can exchange molecules. And exactly with this molecular communication, the symbiosis is able to take place. Both the coral as well as the zooxanthellae, so the algae, have their benefits from it. The algae receive carbon dioxide from the respiration of the corals, and they constantly stay in the euphotic zone by occupying the corals. They also get protection from UV radiation. The corals, on the other hand, receive organic carbon from photosynthesis without any high costs really, as well as nutrients in general. That leads to higher growth rates and higher calcification rates, providing structure and building a healthy reef. Also, the coral can store toxins from the algae as a defense mechanism. Now, when mean temperatures rise for over a degree for at least a month, that symbiosis is broken. Corals' heat tolerance is very limited, and thermal stress then leads to a physiological change in the corals, and they can't hold the zooxanthellae any longer, so they release them. And that is what we call coral bleaching. Because when the zooxanthellae are released, the corals lose their color and bleach. The longer a colony is bleached, the more polyps die off. Mortality increases even further when bleaching is not only a single event, but with repetitive bleaching. So if it occurs more often, when mass bleaching events are many, many repetitive bleaching events at once or over a season. So, in the end, what is the biggest factor or the biggest threat causing corals to bleach? And I think you probably guessed it right already. It is climate change.